Hi guys, it's me again. Making quite a few videos lately, but I just want to again share something a little with you, with something really simple, the grate. The grate of the for the wood gasifier. Something so simple, you know, can maybe produce havoc for you or not, right? It all depends on, but it's there's a lot of pictures on the internet, and it always seems that the grate is always in a bowl shaped, you know, like it's a bowl. And I've lately tried something else, and it seems to really work for me. The bowl shape, I find, it seems to really want to hold the wood inside it, and that's why we have to shake it most of the time, because, well, to release it from, you know, and get the new stuff, the new wood coming down. So basically, I'll just show you quickly the old one I have here. This is the old shaker, or pardon me, the old grate that I had. And as you can see, I mean, it worked great. Everything was awesome. This is kind of like my the inverted bell. I changed this as well. Basically, you know, if you'd see, that would basically sit in there, and you know, you'd shake it and it'd rattle everything out, and it would stick up at about, you know, about an inch up, and just kind of, you know, rattle in there. So anyways, I did change a little bit. I found I had some bridging issues because this hole here was a little small. This hole right now is that was about two inches. So I put a straight pipe on there to make it three. So you can see there's a circle there where the original was, and basically I put one inside there now that's about roughly 3 inches rather than just two. So that's another key factor why I'm not getting bridging. So again, like I said, when this thing is inside here, you know, and the wood is burning, okay, and when you shake the grate, yeah, sure, but the problem I found was when there's wood inside here, it needs to flow over top and then out, okay? And that can be a problem, and that's probably why you get, you know, bridging issues in the first place. So, here, I'll even prove it. Let me just set this down here for a sec. All right, there we go. And I'll get some chips, wood chips. Okay. Just real quick, so if I put some wood inside like that, okay, just like this, put some more in there, all right. So again, make sure that you guys see that. All right, so again, once I lift this up, okay, you can see on the bottom they come out. And basically, when I have the shaker, it comes out. See that? Comes really well. Now, the problem is, let's say if I added more into it right now. Let's add more. There we go, it's full up again. All right. Now, this thing's full again. Now, if this was an inch again, up again, okay, like it is, it's not really, it is coming out, but it's having a little bit harder time, okay? So, unless these are completely burned, and then fall through the holes, it works great, right? But I honestly think that this was, you know, this was getting me a little bit of bridging issues, but it's great, it was simple, but I just, these sidewalls are the problem. So I'm just going to put this aside and show my new kind of design that I made. Okay, so this is the new design right here. And here, I'll just put this back a bit. Point that back up. All right, so this grate is a little bit bigger. This one Dan, forgive me. It's actually about 10 and a half inches, not 12. So it's about 10 and a half inches. It is really thin material. This was stainless steel. And it's all colored right now. It's because of the soot. But originally, that grate was this. So I just put that there on there. So originally this was a barbecue wok, and basically it was like that. So I cut it in the circle. The holes were already drilled and already ready to rock and roll for me. So I took a grinder and just cut that off, and then now I got that. Okay, I'll just put this away again. Now with this, I'm not getting the same issues anymore. So basically what I did was, I think these are just 3/8 rod type of thing that I had on here. Okay, and I just kind of welded another piece of 3/8. These are just, I think they're called eye bolts. So I just put eye bolts on there, spaced out, and every 90 degrees, I believe. And it works great. Now with this, there's no siding on here. There's nothing except for the eye bolts, right? And this really seems to really work for me. So I'll place that down. Okay, and I'll do the same experiment on this. Now let's see if I can place that here. All right, it's a little bit bigger, but there we go. Now if I take this thing and pop it here, let's see. Yeah, you can see that pretty good. I'm gonna fill this up with wood again. Just like this. And just fill that up. Okay, there we go. So now if I go to the bottom here and kind of lift this up about an inch, and maybe this will be better if I have it back here. All right. So if I have that, I'm just gonna lift this up just a hair, okay? Lift this up, and you can see it's already coming out. Now if I shake it, it spreads out more, as you can see, okay? And it flows off to the sides. All right, now that seems to really work. Like you barely even need to use the shaker for it, but it just seems to want to just flow a lot more easier. I mean, tell me if I'm wrong, guys, but I mean, this seems to work for me, that it's more flat and it could, it can move out and just fall easily, onto onto the ground there. So, or my ashtray. So, basically, and then, another thing I wanted to tell you guys is, this little thing too. I found, I have a lot of charcoal down here. After this is done, I mean, I still have tons in here, okay? This is what's left in there. There's a little bit of an unburned piece there, but this is what's left. And what I do is I reuse this. I don't chuck this or throw it in the garbage. I reuse that. And basically, I put this in a little grate like that, shake it, and I got my chunks in there that I can reuse when I want to restart this thing. So just a quick video. It's nothing really much. It does good. Oh, and another big thing I wanted to show you. Flash put a cone inside. You guys probably can't see. I need to get the flashlight here. All right. I put a cone in mine too, okay? So I put a cone, and that really makes a big difference too. So the cone inside there works absolutely amazing. The the fuel basically flows through so much more easier. I thought, okay, how much of a difference would it make? It makes it quite a big difference. So again, that if that helps out everybody, anybody out there type of deal. But don't get me wrong, this works great, okay? But I honestly think when this thing is, you know, pushing side to side like that, it's harder to get rid of this stuff. So it either is going to push it over the walls like that, and then finally get rid of it. But that's, you know, the shaker grate, I mean, that's why it's for, okay? But with this thing here, it seems to work easier. Like, I still shake the grate, but it's a lot less needed. It works very well because it just pushes to the side. I mean, again, this stainless steel is really thin, you know. It may warp a little bit, but like I said, this is one of my key things I found kind of works, and hopefully this helps the wood gas community. So anyways, again, just a little short video, show you guys what works for me, and hopefully everything works out. But again, I'm not bashing anybody's designs or anything like that. I'm just saying what's working for me. You know, I think everything works good, and I think everything's all a learning process. So anyways, again, hope this helps anybody out, and I'll talk to you guys later.